I actually was in the back of a Scotch ruck, and they were kicking shit out of me, put it that way. None more than Laidlaw, but I came out with the ball out their side, and I was able to hit the halfback's arm as he was passing it, and so the ball shot along the ground, and I kicked the ball, but he did a cartwheel at the same time. And, well, this Laidlaw come out the back of the, because he'd been giving me hell in the back of the ruck, and he screamed at the referee, "You just see that dirty bastard, you see what?" It was him that got me sent off, because I've always told Keller, "You didn't really see it, did you?" And he reckons he did, but...
Day from Dublin in Ireland, here for you tonight, please welcome referee Kevin Kelleher. So you finally reckon it's safe, do you?
Yeah, after 21 years, yes. Yeah.
Boy, have we got a surprise for you.
Most people realise that he didn't intend to kick him. He wasn't a kicker either. I mean, he wouldn't kick people, he'd whack them, but he wouldn't kick them. It was a sad occasion, it's one no one wants to... But I can always remember when I got back to New Zealand, I said, I want to be remembered as an all-black, not as a player who was sent off. I think I've achieved that, you know, somewhere along the line. Oh, won't you concede? Even heroes have the right to dream, and it's not easy to be me.
Protein shake?
Steak and eggs.
Team physio.
Colin Meads.
Interchange bench?
Not in my bloody day. Or anything. I can't stand to fly. I'm not that naive. Men want men to ride with clouds between their knees. I'm only a man, no silly.
You get people like Colin Meads, he was a really dedicated man. They say probably you can't train in some areas or even in London, but Colin Meads would get all the young blokes out early in the morning. He'd even run around Park Lane, around Hyde Park, and he'd rub off on these young fellas the way they should train, how they should run. To me, he's a tremendous man from the point of view of bringing a young fellow along.
So here I am now with Sid going. What did you think of the day?
Oh, this has been a marvellous, absolutely marvellous thing, and recognising Colin and Stan. Both those guys I have a tremendous amount of love for, because when I first started in the North Island, South Island games, they were the two locks that brought me in and protected me.
Yeah. Train and it's not easy to be me. I wish that I could cry, fall upon my
I always remember second test in 1960. I always thought it was one of my greatest tests, and I actually played number 8 that day, and I was lucky enough to score a try, and I got the ball from a chap called Kevin Laidlaw, who was running at centre. He had a dab and passed it inside to me, and I scored, you know, I'll say 40 yards away, but it was only about 20. But
you can be with him and you think, well, You know, Pointy, if we go and sign him here, we'll be here till after midnight. Let's get out of this park. And he said, oh, there's just a couple more here that need a bit of a hand. What the hell do you say?
It's like everything in life. If you just be yourself and don't try and be somebody else, which I often tell modern-day pro rugby players, it all comes right. And I've enjoyed it.
One superstition, getting the telegram. Werner would always send him one before a big game.
Never ever got any acknowledgement whatsoever, but for some reason I just kept on sending them. And then Colin was away in South Africa and I was halfway to Tamariniu and I suddenly realised that I hadn't sent Colin this usual telegram. And, didn't matter because he won't notice. And I found out afterwards that he'd checked and checked and rechecked at the hotel before he went out and got in on the bus and even went back and again to find out and still nothing there for him. That was the day that he had his arm broken in South Africa, so it was my fault he got it broken. I'm in New Zealand, he's in South Africa, but it's my fault. About a home I'll never see. It may sound absurd, but don't be naive.
Colin was regarded as a player who would never take a step back. He had a few famous confrontations with players, and generally he would come off better.
Sometimes players or teams would get an unfair advantage by some of the things they were doing, which we thought were illegal, and so you went out of your way to put that right and to sort of make sure that it didn't happen. My attitude was that we had to win, and that you know, you didn't want anyone getting an unfair advantage over you. Or anything. I can't stand to fly. I'm not that naive. Men want men to ride with clouds between.
Relief to first wear it and become an All Black, and to me it was just everything. It's not easy to be me.